will give us also another important, will address another important topic that is even more important globally. Please, Christoph.
Thank you, Fortunato. Let me once again thank ESMO for coming to Vienna. That is something we really loved and which we enjoyed having you enormously, having you all here, and having you all here. Now, when we started out with the question, what would Vienna set apart from other cities in Europe, one of the answers was because we definitely are historically at the crossroads, of course, of different cultures and of different attitudes, but also we're also at the crossroads of different social systems. Particularly ever since the European Union has been enlarged, and where countries from Eastern, Southeastern Europe, Western Europe are now within one union. And the question that emerges here, of course, is particularly in cancer care, how much access patients would have in all the countries of Europe to innovations and to this, what has been reported here. That is an important aspect because we believe that new drugs and the access to efficient drugs is very much connected with treatment outcomes. And that's what the curves in the end show. The curves that you see always show better progression-free survival or even overall survival with a new drug. And the question is, are these new drugs being introduced into the market in a similar way, with a similar speed, and with a similar efficacy and broadly enough? Now, let me come back to a presentation which was done here and where there was a press conference on Friday, I believe, on the economic burden of malignant neoplasms in the European Union, which was presented by Ramon Luengo Fernandez from the University of Oxford, together with Richard Sullivan from the King's College in London. Now, what you find there is that not only are costs by cancer types different in that breast cancer carries the highest healthcare costs of about 6 billion euros, which accounts for about 13% of total healthcare costs, there are other cancers which generate a huge economic burden, which is bigger, like for instance lung cancer, which has the highest economic burden at euro 19 billion, which would mean, when you look at this in a reversed way, that if you would deliver appropriate treatments and appropriate drugs to these patients, the healthcare economic burden might go down, although the treatment costs might even increase. But still, the economic burden might go down because then patients would need less secondary or tertiary care, they would remain in the working process, they would still be able to continue their work. Now, in contrast to that, this investigation showed that there are per capita healthcare costs which differ enormously within the European Union, and this is between 32 euros in the year 2009 and 165 euros per capita. Which means, in other words, that we do have different health systems, and thus, which would imply this, we would also have a different access to drugs. Now, one of the most important aspects that we want to cover, and that is what the President always stands for and what she always is articulating, is that we should definitely have an equal access to cancer drugs within at least the European Union or at least Europe, which ESMO is sort of representing by uniting the different specialists. The fact that drugs are being in a country or not being in a country also leads to differences in both treatment outcomes and even mortality, as Dr. Peter Boyle will show in a couple of minutes, according to an analysis which was published recently. So the topic that we would be focusing now would be how to increase the access to a to optimal care in a similar way. And the European Union is making steps in this direction. I find this very encouraging, in that there is the consideration of a regulation that once after drugs will have been registered, the duration of time until reimbursement is being regulated in all countries will be shortened to a very short and very defined period, which already would generate a lot of momentum and a lot of advantage. So obviously there is there are attempts to understand and to regulate things, but we want to make sure that the proceedings that we make and which are also presented during this conference are benefiting to all people in a union in a similar way. Thank you.